In this lesson, we will look at the relationship of the area of a circle to its circumference. We will start with a circle having a radius r, a circumference c, and an area of A. We split the circle into two halves, and now you can see that what we have here is this piece has half the circumference out here, as you can see out here, and the other piece has half the circumference out here. We further subdivide each of the half circles into small slices as shown out here. In this case, we have divided each half circle into 10 slices. Now that we have reassembled the pieces back into this different shape, the first thing we understand is that the area of this shape is equal to the area of the original circle. Now let's look at this shape in more detail. This is roughly a rectangular shape. And if you make the pieces smaller and smaller, this becomes an almost perfect rectangle. Now, what are the dimensions of the rectangle? As you can see, this part which I am marking out here, which is slightly curved, is half of the circumference of the circle, that is c by 2, because this line represents the other half of the circumference of the circle. Now the height of the rectangle is the same as the radius of the circle, because this is the original radius of the circle. So this is r. So now we get our relation between the area and the circumference. What do we get? We get c by 2 multiplied by r equals the area of the circle. We get a relationship between the area and the circumference of the circle as area equals circumference multiplied by radius divided by 2. If we know that the circumference equals 2 pi times radius and we put it here, then we get the result that the area must be pi r squared. The important thing that we learned in this lesson is to understand the relationship between the area and the circumference of a circle.